Hello people, my name is Mohit and welcome to my first tutorial on YouTube. In this tutorial, we'll go over the topic of keying in Blackmagic Fusion 8. Let's get started. We have our source loaded into the flow area. Selecting the loader, we'll hit Shift Spacebar. That will bring the Add tool menu and search for PrimeAdd by typing the first few letters of the tool. That will add PrimeAdd to the flow. We'll go ahead and select the double view icon so that we have two viewers. To see the effect of PrimeAdd, we will click and drag the PrimeAdd tool into the viewer 1. You can't see any effect, that is because we haven't changed any settings on the PrimeAdd. Click and drag the PrimeAdd into the second viewer as well. Click on Fit. We'll also click on this button to get the alpha view. Select the PrimeAdd tool. On the right hand side, we can see the settings of the PrimeAdd. First, click on Auto Compute. That will give us a pretty decent key straight away. Next, I'll click on Clean Background Noise. Select Box from here. Click and drag in areas where we need solid black, that is the transparent areas. Now, click on Clean Foreground Noise. Click and drag in areas where we need solid white, that is the areas that we want to keep. Now, if you see here, we have a pretty nice key. For the spill suppression, we'll use this clip. There is a lot of evidently visible green spill on a subject here, which will help us understand the despill method better, as the results will be more evident as compared to the previous clip. As earlier, I have added the PrimeAdd and I've got my key. Now, there are two things. One, we have lots of green spill around the hair, on her face, and on the reflective dress, which we have to remove. Second, we have this tracking object, which we do not need. First, we'll get rid of the unwanted object. For that, we will add a polygon mask by clicking on this icon. Connect it to the garbage mat input of PrimeAdd. Select the polygon and we'll draw a mask around the subject. Well, that's not the result we want. Not to worry, go to the settings, click invert. That will bring our subject back and the unwanted object is removed. Let us add a little bit of feather to the mask. Now, getting to the spill suppression, let us add a matte control mode. Connect the source clip to the background input of the matte control. Drag it to viewer 2. Go to spill, select green because our background is green. Push the spill suppression all the way to 1. As of now, we don't get a satisfactory result. The spill method is set to rare. We'll try different algorithms, but I think Weldon suits our purpose here. It gives us a decent result, but it can be better. If you compare our source clip with the despilled one, there is a luminance difference, and I would like to add that luminance back into the despill. For that, first we'll extract the spill out of our source clip and then add it to the despill. For extracting the spill, we will have to subtract this from this. To do that, I'll add a channel booleans node. Connect the source to the background and the matte control to the foreground of the channel booleans. Change the operation to subtract and alpha to do nothing. We have our spill extracted, which can be added back into the despill. Before that, I'll add a brightness contrast node so that we have more control. Take the saturation all the way down. Add another channel booleans. Connect this to the background and this to the foreground. Change the operation to add. That is what we get. I'll do one thing. Add the source to A and this one to B. You can see that we have achieved similar luminance. Next step is spill replacement. First, we will add a background node. Connect the output of the background node to the output of the brightness contrast node. It will automatically add a merge node in between. Change the apply mode to multiply. Now, select the background node. Click on this arrow that will bring up the color wheel. Drag the merge into the viewer 2. Now, if I move around in the color wheel, you'll see that the spill is replaced by the color I select. Okay, so why is this important? To show that, I'll go ahead and connect the output of the dspill or the channel boolean to the output of the primat with a merge tool. Now, this is what we get. Let us also take the output of the primat and connect it to the effect mask input of the merge. Now, we have our key along with the spill suppression. We will also add a background for our key, which is an image I pulled out of Google. Our background has more resolution, so I have added a resize node to bring it to 1920x1080 fit. Connect the output of this merge to the output of the background. Let's view it in the viewer. Now, if I select the background and change the color to maybe purple, you'll see that the spill is matching this color. But this region, it would have been better if we could get the sun's yellowish color affecting that region. So let us try and get the background itself to affect the spill. For doing so, first I'll add a blur node. Connect the background into the blur node. Let us increase the blur value. And connect the blur into the foreground input of the merge. Now if you see, the spill is replaced by the colors from our background. To make this effect more obvious, I'll select the brightness contrast and increase the gain value. So you get to see what exactly this is doing. Get the gain value to the default. Next step is color matching. From here on, we'll be using the previous clip. So this is what we have. Our key after the spill suppression and replacement. This is our background. For color matching, we will go ahead and add a color correction node. Now, connect the background to the foreground of the color correction node. In the settings, go to histogram and click on match. Oh, that is too much. Once again, two things that we need to take care of. First, we don't need the color match to affect the alpha region. So, we will connect the output of the merge to the effect mask of the color corrector. That takes care of our first problem. Second, we need to dial down the effect of the color match. So, we'll bring this slider down, maybe till there. Also, increase the smooth out correction curve. Next step would be relighting. Though it's not a necessary step, we can certainly use it for getting some interesting results. It will all depend on the mood and feel that you want to achieve in a shot. First, we will add a bitmap mask. Connect the color correction to the bitmap. Now, add another bitmap to this. Connect the color correction node into the background input. Change the mode to subtract. Right now, we can only see a black solid. We'll select the move tool and move it like this. Now we have a mask for just that region of our key. To make it more interesting, we will feather the mask by sliding up the soft edge. We'll also go to image and click on frame to get rid of that at the bottom. Now to the second bitmap, we will add another color correction node. Connect this to the background input of this CC node. Let's view it in the viewer. Now, if we move the gain, you can see what it does. Let us go for a value of 1.1. You can see the difference that it makes. To make this process more interesting, let us copy these three nodes, Ctrl-C, and paste, Ctrl-V. Let us make all the right connections as earlier. Now, select the second bitmap and click on Invert. Go to image and click on frame again. Now, select the color corrector. First, click on reset all color changes. Then, in the midtones, bring the lift value down. So now, we have transition from here to here. Next, light wrap and edge blur. We can certainly do it manually, but here I'll be using the wrapper node. Hit Ctrl-B to bring up this window and go to macros. Double click on the wrapper. The wrapper is added to the flow. Connect the background to the background input of the wrapper and this to the foreground. If we view the wrapper in the viewer, we have the background and our key combined. Let us change some settings in the wrapper. Go all the way down. Click on Output Wrap Only for visualization purpose. Now, let us click on Use Luma Keyer. Take Wrap Size Up. We'll keep this at default. Alpha Gain Down and the Blend Down as well. So this is the light wrap we have. By clicking Use Luma Keyer on and off, we can see what it does. Let's increase this effect. Click on Do Wrap 2. This time we will leave this option off. Let us push the wrap size a long way up this time. Bring this halfway down, alpha gain down, and the blend further down. Click on Use Color Wrap, increase the saturation, push the color wrap size up, and bring the gain down. Next, click on Edge Blur, view edge for visualization of what we are doing. Push this slightly up, this one a little down, up, leave it at default. Increase the blur size. These settings are self-explanatory. You should play around with it to achieve the results that you are looking for. Off Output Wrap Only. To see the effect of the wrapper, let us add a merge node and make the connections. If we drag these both into the viewer, we can see the difference. Let us delete the merge node. We do not need it. For grading, as you would have guessed, we will add a color correction node. These adjustments are based on personal preferences and the mood we are going for. I'll take the shadows to the bluish purple around there, the midtones to the light yellow, and the highlight towards the cyan. Let us also increase the gain value to 1.15. In the midtones, get the gamma to 1.1. And in the shadows, get the lift value down. For further grading, let us go to Tools, Film, Light Trim. Increase the value to 2. Yet again, go to Tools, Film, Film Grain. Tweak the settings to achieve the results that we are looking for. There. Now, if you compare these two, you will be able to see the grains. Next, we'll add a vignette. For that, first add a color correction. Add a circular mask. Tweak the mask. Select the CC node and bring the lift value down. Drag it to the viewer. We need to change the mask settings. Increase the feather and click on invert. There, we have our final result. So that is it for now. There'll be more videos like this coming up soon. So stay tuned. See ya.